Let me set the framework for chapter 1. Nehemiah had a visitor. He asked his brother and his family, how are people in Jerusalem doing? And they told him about the condition of Jerusalem, which was his hometown. Now keep in mind, Nehemiah never lived in Jerusalem. He never lived in Jerusalem. His family was from there. He was in exile in Persia. But he had learned that the wall had been destroyed by King Nebuchadnezzar. King Nebuchadnezzar had destroyed Jerusalem 152 years before. He had knocked down the walls and burned the city's gates. Nehemiah broke down and wept when he heard that Jerusalem walls had fallen. The boulders was crushed in and materials burnt. Jerusalem lie there in waste. Folks went about their business, not caring what was going on. No desire to do nothing. The burden was on Nehemiah. Now you gotta keep in mind, he took on a burden for a city that he's never lived in, never been to.
That's good.
So let's look at Nehemiah, the second chapter. I'm going to start at the first verse through the 17th verse. Now, when you get a chance, I do want you to go back and read Nehemiah, the first chapter, because in order to do an inspired work, you have to pray first. The first ingredient of an inspired work is prayer. All right, let's start with Nehemiah, the second chapter. And it came to pass in the month of Nisan, in the 20th year of Ahasuerus the king, that wine was before him. I took up the wine and gave it unto the king. Now I had not been before time sad in his presence. Wherefore the king said unto me, why is thy countenance sad, seeing thou art not sick? This is nothing else but sorrow of heart. Now I was very sore afraid, and said unto the king, let the king live forever. Why should not my countenance be sad when the city, the place of my father's sepulcher, lieth waste, and gates thereof are consumed with fire? Then the king said unto me, for what doest thou make request? So I prayed to the God of heaven. Prayer first, folks. Prayer for first. And I said unto the king, if it please the king, and if thou servant have found favor in thy sight, that thou would send me unto Judah, unto the city of my father's sepulcher, that I may build it. And the king said unto me, the queen was sitting beside him, for how long shall the journey be? When would thou return? So I pleased the king, and I pleased the king to send me, and I set him a time. Moreover, I said unto the king, if it please the king, let letters. There is planning come into place. Your first is prayer, man's planning.
I love it.
Moreover, I said unto the king, if it please the king, let letters be given to the governor beyond the river, that they may convey me over till I come into Judah. And a letter was sent unto Asa, the keepers of the king's forest, that he may be given timber, here we go into preparation, to make beams for the gates of the palace, which appertain to the house, for all the wall of the city, and for the house that I should enter into. The king granted me his favor, and the king granted me according to the good hand of my God upon me. Preparation brings on favor. Ninth verse, then I came to the governors beyond the river, and gave them the letters, the king's letters. And the king has sent captains of the army and horsemen with me. When Sanballat, the Horonite, and Tobiah, the servant an Amorite heard of it, it grieved them exceedingly that there was come a man to seek the welfare of the children of Israel.
All right,
yeah. So I came to Jerusalem. Uh-huh. I was there 3 days. And I arose in the night, and I saw few men with me. Mm-hmm. Neither told I any man that my God put in my heart to do at Jerusalem. Sometimes you can't tell people what you're going to do. Neither was there any beast with me, save the beast that I rode on. I went up by night, by the gate of, I went out by night by the gate of the valley, even before the dragon well, and to the dung court, and to view the walls of Jerusalem, which was broken down, and the gates thereof was consumed with fire. Then I went to the gate of the fountain and to the king's pool, but there was no place for the beast that was under me to pass. It was such a mess, not even fit for an animal to rest. Then went I up into the night by the brook and viewed the wall and turned back and entered by the gate of the valley and so returned. And the rulers knew not whether I went or what I did.
Yes.
Sometimes you can't tell people what you're doing. It's not their
come on.
Burden.
Yeah.
It's not going to be their business.
Wow.
Nor to the priests, nor to the nobles, nor to the rulers, nor to the rest that did the work. Then I said unto them, seeing the distress that we are in, here's conviction. How Jerusalem laughed and waves. This is what he was feeling. He was feeling the conviction of what he was seeing, the distress of Jerusalem and the gates thereof burnt with fire. Come and let us build up the wall of Jerusalem that we be no more a reproach. Conviction brings on correction. Amen.
Amen.